recite. Recycling of electronic waste. So next point is recycling of electronic waste. Okay. So in this recycling, okay, of e-waste, that is electronic waste. Okay, sorry, electronic of e-waste. Is nothing but electronic waste. Okay, so let's discuss of this point. The history show that lifespan of average lifespan of PC was 4.5 years. Use electronic contain significant amount of hazardous material such as mercury, lead, cadmium, but the same time it contains high value materials such as gold, copper and plastic. So computer recycle are normally large companies or government program. They need to handle high volume of recycling materials to make their business profitable. Some reason not to recycle old equipment include not knowing how to properly dispose of equipment. The equipment is donated to NGO or might be used in future. The possibility that the equipment can be sold to another organization. Most computers recycle, remarket working parts and entire computers because they are able to recognize higher profit than through smelting recover the materials. So some most equipment are reason not recycle. I said now why not recycle it, and some equipment can be recycled. So recycle of e-waste electronic equipment. So here we have to study about refurbishing. Refurbishing means damaged equipment to bring. The next point is the meaning of these, it means damaged equipment to bring it to workable or better looking condition. Means jo bhi damaged equipment hai usko again recycle karke usko better condition mein convert karna. When refurbisher receive discarded computers, okay, it takes them, extracts a usable part from computer and fix the ones that can be fixed. When refurbishable receive discard part, it extract usable part from computer that are not repairable, and then fix the ones that can be fixed. Missing part replace such as hard drive, memory and cards, CD-ROM, a fan, battery and power supply slot covers can be replaced if needed. Computer can be refurbishing according to the specific client specification. One working computer can be built from 3 to 4 non-working computer. The other non-recycling parts can be sent to recycling companies. One has to sure care that sensitive information does not fall into the wrong hands. While refurbishing the parts, refurbishing can be divided into non-commercial refurbisher and commercial furnishers. So non-commercial means and commercial means, let's see, the means the major is to repair or upgrade instead of recycling the donating the use of electronic equipment. Refurbishing and the donate of computer to school and job training organization. There are infrastructure to collect, refurbish and distribute unused and obsolete computers. This market turns around the reused computer and provide them to low-income families. Larger programs such as Computer for School Canada, first called in New York, and Student Recycling Use Technology in Portland. Okay, then the commercial refurbishing, that is the most major computer companies have their own division for repurposing computer companies such as Apple, IBM, HP Service, Dell, has made it easy for you to recycle your used computer to equipment through their reconnected a partnership with Goodwill Industry. So simply take your old computer equipment of any brand in any condition to one of Goodwill's 2000 participating locations throughout North America, and we will make sure your system and associates are refurbishing or recycle responsible. So for this, make the decision here. We have to make decision.
Day night.
So life cycle to make decision means make decision. One has take decision in organization of what organization is going to do with computer. One has to. There are different options like resell the equipment in marketplace, then manufacture the equipment and send it for recycling, giving it to the recycling agency, providing community service by donating the computer, tax deduction for any your donation for recycling contribution. If the age of computer is more than 5 years, then it's better to exchange computer. So this is the decision of in the organization of what organization is going to do with computer one has. Means there are different options which I explained, means said here that this is the decision of life cycle of the suppose computer. So there are different options like resell the equipment in marketplace. Okay, you can resell the in marketplace, then de-manufacture the equipment and send it for recycling. But the de-manufacture karne ke baad usko recycling ke liye you can send it, giving it to the recycling agency. So recycling agency ko you can give it, providing the community service by donating the computer, tax deduction for any your donation of recycling contribution. If the age of computer is more than 5 years, then it's better to exchange computer. So this is about the make decision is about computer here. If it is above 5, then we have to exchange it. Then life cycle. A product life cycle takes all parts of the computer's life into consideration. Product life cycle takes all the phase of product into the consideration. Means life cycle means suppose term. Okay, term is given. So in terms you can say one has to define objective for the development of new system, identify the need of replacing your organization computer. Means the recycle of some points are given. First terms, in terms we want to say that one has to define objective for the development of new system. Okay, then identify the need of replacing your organization computer. Then feasibility study. Second point is in recycling is that is a feasibility study. Feasibility study. So here one need to update components of this existing system rather than completely replace it. Then feasibility study saves your money and it also prevents a computer from having to be recycled. Then fact finding. Third one is a fact finding. So here fact finding is an essential skill set in your existing system and how it is being used. If you stay in this role, at some point you will end up doing investigation. You have to monitor your staff and ask them how they use the system. then it is a good to be observed, which will give you an idea that how the system is used. Okay, so here often people will not be completely forthcoming with their answer because they need higher to be embarrassed about the parts of the system they have trouble using. Okay, then analysis. So here one has to think about their ideal system, taking into the consideration the above mentioned terms. We can build our own model, means whatever is above mentioned of the terms and feasibility study, fact finding. So terms having the one has to define the objective for the development of new system, then identify the need, replacing your means you have to identify the need why you want to replace your replacing your organization computer. Then feasibility study, in this ones need to update component of the existing system there rather than complete replace. Okay, so need to update component of the existing system rather than the complete replace it. Then feasibility study saves your money and also prevent computer from the having the to be recycled. Then fact finding is an essential skill set in your existing system and how it is being used. If you stay in this role, at some point you will be end up doing investigation. You have to monitor your staff and ask them how they use system. It is good to be observed, which will give you an idea that how its system is used. Often people will not be completely forthcoming with their answer because they might be embarrassed about the parts of the system they have trouble using, right? So in analysis, this is all part of about terms, feasibility study and fact finding. So one has to think about their ideal system, taking into consideration the above mentioned terms. We can build our own model. So then design. So it is a stage based on the above model has one to build a real model. Use whatever elements you can form the analysis section. At this stage, you produce the document that describes the system, but it needed not contain the specific brand or models of hardware or software. System specification. System specification. So here, in this, the system specification helps to define the operational and performance guideline for the system. It may outline how the system is expected to the perform. When purchasing software or hardware system, specification may be outlined during the evaluation process and agree upon during the payment process. At this stage, you choose exact model, brands, and identify the supplier. So this is in system specification that when purchasing software or hardware system, specification may be outlined during the evaluation process and agree upon during the payment process. At this stage, you choose exact model, brand, and identify suppliers. Then implementation and review. Then after the stage is last stage is the no. This is not last stage. Implementation and review. So here, the staff, the turn, the necessary change are made to improve the performance. Once the new system is working successfully, then you can get rid of the component of the old system. Okay, then use. Use the new system every day. Maintain and update your system it as needed. Use your system for optimal functionality. Then close. So in this stage, you can close the old system and migrate data to more modern system. At this stage, you need decide what you will do with your data and think about how the machine will be disposed of. Okay, so after this recycle points, see the life. According to the author, today and a system life is based on, means we have to see the system's life here. So according to the author, okay, to buy a system life based on three factors. So system's life is three factors. It's based on the three factors here. Okay, just let me. Okay. Based on three factors. Okay. So let's see these factors. First one, useful life. Useful life. Then second is the technological life. Technological life. And third one is the economic life. Economic life. Okay. So this is the base three factors. So according to the authors today, system life is based on the three factor useful life. In this, the expression the equipment lifetime, in which eventually equipment wears out and it's not feasible to repair us anymore. Then technological life, in this a system may become impractical to maintain, even though it can still be repaired, okay, and maintained. For example, it might not be possible to find the right type of memory chip for the system because they are no longer made. Another way to look at this is obsolescence. Then economic life. A system might still functional, but it costs too much to use. It might also that newer system can be purchased that have lower operating cost, so that payback periods of making that purchase is short. So there are the important factors related to cost you will be include while evaluating system's life cycle. So initial phase price, that is one can spend more money on the upfront purchase price in the hope or that lower operating cost can be lower down. So energy cost, high performance computer need additional cooling and more power, right? So maintain, if one by computer by considering less effort over cost, that there are chance to pay more in maintenance cost. Example, if hard drives and don't work properly, one has spent more in money fixing this computer. Replacement. Plan for replacing component or even entire computers, whereas the pre-sending are cost you can expect for the physical machine. There are other costs associated with your system. That system should be added into your cost estimate. So in indirect costs include as following, like interest may be the largest indirect cost to your system. In the interest you pay on borrowing. So here interest, administrative cost and staffing downtime. So these are the indirect costs including following. So here so maybe the largest indirect cost to your system in the interest, you may be borrowing money to make the initial purchase, as such as should figure your interest cost into any life cycle cost consideration. So administrative cost, it will change depending the organization type and system to system. It includes cost for arranging the administrative service agreements, tracking equipment with properly tax and so forth. Staffing, you may find that you need more or less people depending on your system. Okay, this come in staffing. and stuff. According to that, one has planned to impact of those salaries into your life cycle cost estimate. So downtime, if the system is down, it reduces the productivity. If you plan regular update and maintain, you should be able to predict how often you shall have to take the system down and what the impact will be the overall organization productivity. So lease, what are the benefits of leasing your equipment? So keeping your equipment up to date, as the technology is changing, the computer become obsolete quickly. Once will not get in financial burden for computer ops. After explanations of the lease, one can change computer and can search for new deal. Predictable monthly expense. You shall always know what you are spending on your machine because you have already have out deal to your what you are repaying. Low or no cost. The low cost will lower down the down payment. Staying capability. If it is important that you will be technological equal, that is or better with your competitors, so gives you as an option to get the latest and greatest equipment with regular interval, paying more overall. One has to take care that leasing will not become more expensive than outright buying. A deal is a deal. In leasing, one has to pay for the equipment even if you don't use equipment anymore. If your business change or lease equipment is no longer needed, but you are still make the monthly payment. So in this, what are the pros and cons of buying equipment? Advantages and disadvantages of buying equipment. So easy in comparison to leasing. The when we buy equipment, then you own the that equipment. You do not spend your time with missing agreement and returning the equipment. Then maintain is up to you. When you own the computers, you can decide when you follow maintenance schedule. Then tax deductibility. If you buy the computer, you may get benefit in tax. If you lease, you can write off the monthly cost. Example cons. So high initial. If you buy your computer, you have to spend that money upfront. That money could have been used to build the business through marketing, advertising, or something else. You are stuck with it. With the lease, when the lease terms is over and machine go back to the lease company, disposal becomes that company problem, not yours. However, you can you own the computer, you have to figure out how to recycle the machine. So this is about the buying the machines, your equipment. This is a advantage and disadvantage, you can say. So in upcoming next week, you see the green design. So green design. What do you mean by green design? When you design your system, one has to think of it. Important that one should keep in mind in life consideration, environmentally responsible use, retirement and disposal. Okay, let me increase the volume first. Okay, so what do you mean by green design? When you design your system, okay, one has to think of its important. When we design our system, we have to think it's the system's important that one should keep in the mind. And life cycle consideration, environmentally responsible use, retirement and disposal. मतलब कोई भी design system करने जा रहा है environmentally कितनी कसर responsible से वो कितनी मतलब harmful हो ने या type से अपने system शक्य तो design करना पड़ेगा. Okay, so what are the points one has keep in mind while designing system? So some points are there. Design for repair, you can say. Just 1 minute. Design for repair. Design for repair. So what are the points one has to keep in mind while designing system? So design a system where you can repair the equipment. Okay, design for upgrading great ability. Okay, upgrade, it should be upgraded. Whether by the means build a system that can be upgraded rather than having to replace entire components when needed. Means component replace karne se lagi they upgrade hona chahiye. You know, you can update your mobile right after some time. I mean, you can updation it after mobile, but we don't need to replace our mobile. Our mobile inbuilt is there, we have got the message updating, then we keep in update. Like this system also chahiye ki replace karne se lagi we have to means build system that can be upgrade rather than having to replace entire component when needed. Then design to minimize power consumption. So here second maybe how to means mind design system means what are the point one has to keep in mind while designing system. So designing of repair having first point, that is a design for upgradability. Then so this is the first point, design for upgradability. It means while designing a system means build a system that can be upgraded rather than having to replace entire component when needed. Then design to minimize power consumption means design to minimize power consumption. Okay, so this is the second point here. The first point, design for repair, that is a design for upgradability. So in this build system that can be upgraded rather than having to replace entire component when needed. Okay, jab is required hai tab it should be replaced. Then second is a design to maintain minimize the power consumption. Means what here? Use equipment which consume the less electricity that will be, have to be generated. Means we have to read that we have used that type of equipment which consume the less electricity. Okay, that will have to be generated. Okay, then design for recycling or clean disposal. So design for recycling or clean disposal. Okay, so in this design system with material types that are easily recycled include the element that are less toxic. Okay, so here design system with material types that are easily recycled, matlab aise type material aapla design kala pahije easily recycle hoil and include the element that are less toxin ani less toxin se element ke include hoila pahije. So yeah, that's a green designing madhe aapla kuch some points. I means you know the green designing is nothing, is the when you design your system and when we can design our system, then we have to think that important one should keep in mind that we in life cycle consideration environmentally responsible use means environmentally responsible use of electrical systems and retirement and disposal. Okay, so rather kahi system delay is designed for repairing delay, like design for upgradability, then design for minimize power consumption and design for recycling. So recycling companies. Okay, so recycling companies, how you select good recycle? Okay, so why selecting recycling company, one should select company which is accountable and maintain good records about what they did with whole machine. Means what here? We have to deal with recycling company here. So here while selecting the recycling company, okay, one should select which is accountable and maintain good record about what they did with old machine. Following points one has to consider while selecting the good recycler. Recycler should give general description of its business, like point of contract, okay, number of employees, year in business, and ownership history. So while selecting the company, okay, one should select company which is accountable and maintain good record about what they did with old machine. Means while you doing the recycling, you have to say like this company which can maintain their account and history also, कि उन्होंने old machine जो भी you want to do recycling उसके साथ कैसे deal किया, okay? So following point has to be considered while selecting the good recycler. So recycler should give general description of its business, like point of contact, number of employee, year in business, ownership history. So recycler should specify the type of product it accepts, service of recycle in which geographical area, and type of organization. Describing fees of electronic recycle for various type of equipment. Describe additional service like on-site collection support, transformation support, product reuse or refurbishment,